हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो
वी कंप्लीटेड विद न्यूटन्स लॉज एंड न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन कंप्लीटली इन आवर लास्ट टर्न एंड टुडे वी आर बिगिनिंग विद अ फ्रेश चैप्टर प्रेशर इन फ्लूइड्स. सो व्हाट एवर कम्स अंडर प्रेशर, व्हाट इज प्रेशर, हाउ इज इट मेजर्ड, व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द प्रेशर and how do the formulae are derived, we are all going to study in this chapter. So we move forward. Now, first we have to understand what is pressure. And to understand pressure, we have to understand two more terms, and that is force and area. Now, one more word comes into the scene, and that is thrust. And what is thrust? Thrust is the total force acting perpendicular to the surface. So any surface, we have to see a surface, and any force which is acting perpendicularly to that surface is known as thrust. So thrust exerted by a body on a surface is equal to weight of the body. Suppose a book is kept on a table. So what is the normal force acting on the table by the book? That is the weight of the book. And hence, weight of the book is the thrust which is acting normally on the table. So that is a force. Thrust is a kind of force which is acting normally on the surface of the table. So, in other words, we have come to know that thrust is also a kind of force. And what kind of force? A force which is acting normally on the surface. So, we move further. Now, we studied thrust is equal to force. So what will be the SI unit for force? It will be the same as that of force. So SI unit of force is SI unit of thrust, and that is Newton. MKS unit is KGF. So 1 KGF is equal to 9.8 Newton. This you have to remember for conversions at various points. And CGS unit is GF, and 1 GF is equal to 980 times. So this you all have to remember for solving various numerical problems. So we move further. So now we come to the word pressure. Pressure is defined as force per unit area. So whatever is the force acting per unit area will be defined as pressure at that point. So pressure is a scalar quantity, and the units of pressure in SI system is taken as Pascal. And if you have to define pressure, you will say pressure is defined as force per unit area. Okay. Now from this definition only, you must have understood that what is the formula for pressure? Pressure is equal to force upon area, and in physics, it is thrust upon area. So 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton upon 1 meter square. 1 Newton is the thrust and 1 meter square is the area. So 1 Pascal, that is the pressure over here, 1 Pascal will be defined as force of 1 Newton acting on 1 meter square. Pressure is same in every direction in a fluid at a given depth. If it were not, fluid would flow. So if a liquid is filled in a container and you have to find out the pressure on a molecule which is inside that liquid, so pressure will be equal from all the sides on that single molecule. If this would not have been the case, the liquid would have been flowing. So pressure is same from all the sides on a molecule which is there inside a liquid. So we move further. Now here we will see what role is area playing in pressure. So pressure is thrust per unit area of the surface. We all have understood by now. Pressure is equal to force upon area. So here we have taken two solids. One is cylindrical in shape and one is somewhat conical in shape. Okay. Now, if you see the first one, the area over there is a circle which is in contact with the surface on which it is standing. It is a circle. It is a circular surface which is in contact with the surface on which it is standing. And in the cone, it is also a circle, but it is of less area. As we can see in the figure, the cylinder is taking a bigger base as compared to the cone, which is taking a smaller base. So in that case, pressure is equal to force upon area, and that means thrust upon area. So what if the weight of these solids is same? In that case, the pressure exerted by the cone will be more. Why? If the denominator is less and we divide the same value with a lesser denominator, we will get a greater value. So pressure will be more in case of a cone. We will see how in the later slides. So we move further. But this we have already studied, that what is the SI unit of pressure? Pressure is equal to force upon area or thrust upon area, that is Newton per meter square, and that is taken as Pascal. So 1 Pascal is the pressure exerted on a surface of 1 meter square by a force of 1 Newton acting normally on it. So we move further. We have already done with this. Now, from where is the unit Pascal given? As Blaise Pascal was the one who has studied on this, and therefore pressure was taken up by him, and so unit for pressure is given on his name, Pascal, and so unit of pressure is 1 Pascal. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per 1 meter square. CGS unit is dyne per centimeter square. So we move further. Now, this is something important to study. Therefore, here we can see in the picture that we have the same cuboid over here. But in one case, the cuboid is kept on a bigger area, and in the other picture, it is kept on a smaller area. The same cuboid, once it is standing on length into breadth, and once it is standing in height into the width over there. So the weight in both the cases will be same, which I was talking about right now. So if it is area, how is area affecting the pressure we are going to study now? If area is more, then what will happen? If area is less, then what will happen? So this is to be studied clearly. So the first picture, which is showing here, weight is 100 Newton. And area is 0.1 meter square. So in that case, the pressure comes to 1000 Pascals. Okay. Now, in the second picture, the area reduces. Obviously, the area will reduce. So area reduces and it comes to 0.01 meter square. And weight is same. Because the cuboid is same, so weight is same. That means the thrust is same, the force is same. So the same force, when divided by 0.01 meter square, the pressure comes to 10,000 Pascals. So you have seen, if area is less, pressure is more. And if area is more, pressure is less. And therefore, we conclude from here that area is inversely proportional to pressure applied. And that is why an elephant moving on a ground filled with sand and a lady moving with pencil heels on the same ground, it is difficult for the lady to move on that ground as area of cross section for her weight of the body is too much. And for the elephant, it will balance itself on the large area of cross section on the foot. Is it okay? Must have understood what is the effect of area on pressure. more the pressure, less the area, and less the more the area, less the pressure. Okay, so we move further. Now this picture is the example of the same thing which we have studied right now. When the boy is lying down, he is covering more area, and when the boy is standing on the mattress, he is covering less area. Obviously, pressure will be more when the area is less, and when he is standing, the depression shown is more as compared to the depression when he is lying down on that mattress. So we move further. Now this is one more example of more the area, less the pressure. In one picture, it is somebody is taking up a finger and trying to insert it in the body of a man. And in the other picture, it is an injection which is being injected in the body of the man. So obviously, the finger will have more area, and so the pressure will be less. And in that case, the finger will not be allowed to penetrate in the body. Whereas, when it is an injection, the area is too less as compared to the finger, and therefore it easily penetrates because of the high pressure over there, and therefore injection can be injected in the body. So these were few examples. You have come to know what is pressure, what is thrust, what is area, what is the effect of each on one another, and what is the SI unit of all. You can go through the numericals relating to this. And we will be covering pressure in fluids in the next part of the chapter. Till then, read the chapter and clear your doubts. If you have any problem, we will discuss it in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.